विल यू आंसर? हेलो हेलो,
हेलो मैडम। जी
हाँ यस सर,
मैम।
हु इज गोइंग टू
हेलो
आंसर? हु इज गोइंग टू आंसर?
मैडम, आई एम राधा कृष्णा फ्रॉम त्रिपली।
यस,
मैडम, नाउ डेज मोस्ट ऑफ द इंजीनियर्स आर थिंकिंग दैट दे शुड अर्न जस्ट मनी। दे आर जस्ट वर्किंग फॉर मनी। इंजीनियर्स डेव टू दे आर द इनोवेटर्स एंड दे नीड टू डेवलप समथिंग न्यू। But nowadays, all the engineers are doing that. They are just adopting the previous technologies and they are just working on it, other than developing the new ones. That's it.
So what they have to do, like, see, a person who does the work or who is an employee of an organization, I feel like though he works, he should have the personal satisfaction, isn't it? So
Yes, ma'am.
some people will be just blindly doing the work given by their head of the department, and they will be doing and they just come out. It's a like daily routine, but giving a satisfaction to, oh, I'm doing something for me and something for my family. I'm doing something new, which is fetching the pennies in my pocket, and it should also give you the satisfaction. That's what an entrepreneur will do, isn't it? The difference between an entrepreneur and an engineer is, engineer, he'll be using his technology, his research and his qualification to do the work. But whereas an entrepreneur, not only he uses his the qualification or whatever the knowledge, but also he will be thinking all around the board, the world. Like, he'll be thinking of the market, he'll be thinking of the innovation. He is a founder of innovation, the profit, the coming out of the profits, taking the risk, isn't it? So an entrepreneur is an all-rounder. Engineer is also an all-rounder, but he has some constraints. But entrepreneur, he can swim the all around, but an engineer, he is having some boundaries in only in his technology he is accustomed, isn't it? But an entrepreneur, he can go into all the fields whatever he want, and he has a rights to choose, isn't it? So if an engineer turns as an entrepreneur, not only in, like, he can use his technology and he can go wide around as he is strong enough in the subject. So he can use that, he can use his subject knowledge and the outside world knowledge, clubbing both will leads to a very good firm. So I suggest you all students, at least from 120 plus 120, I don't know the whole strength of Tripoli and civil, it could be about 200 plus. At least one person, if he becomes a successful entrepreneur, it will give me really a job satisfaction to me. Taking this subject is just a generalized subject, but motivating you in all points is also very, very important to me. So I tell that please put efforts from now. If you have any idea, start jotting the points. Now I have shown some of the approaches, some of the government websites. Go and have a look on it. If you have any like free time, go and look if they are giving any free application forms, or like you can see in Startup India, they are encouraging the young engineers, right? So go and have a look, contact with them, and if you have any references, go and have. If you have, like, you'll see some advertisements like this shop is for lease, so go and have a look and talk with them. The more you communicate, the more you will get the knowledge. You the more knowledge you get, the more ideas you get. So the more ideas you have in the mind, then think on it, in which you are good, and then it leads to a very good entrepreneur or the enterprise, right? So that's a small speech by me. Let's go back to the syllabus now. Right. So in the last class, we were discussing about the different types of like what are the sources of ideas, isn't it? Can you see my slide?
Yes, madam.
Okay. So these were the sources of ideas, like having knowledge from the books or the trade fairs. I said, trade fair is nothing but internationally and national wise. It's a group of association of different products or different enterprises at a place. They will mingle up, and you can have a look of the product. You will get ideas physically by seeing the product, or you can even have a knowledge of what are the latest scientific techniques of the product. So that all discussions you can do it in trade fairs and exhibition. By visiting this international conferences, trade fairs, exhibition, you will have an idea physically also. And even in terms of marketing also, you can see what is the competition of that product, or what are the cost analysis, what are the product analysis, all this you can have a look. So these are the some of the sources of generating the ideas. Okay, then I said about a topic called creativity. What is it? You said some of the people said creativity is nothing but innovation. Creativity is nothing but if you have a problem, from that problem you will get a solution out of it. So to get a solution out of it, you have to do some brainstorming, or some thinking ability should be there in you. So one of the method is creativity. The second method is brainstorming, where sometimes if I sit idle, singly if I sit idle, I may be getting a hundred times of ideas. But if I sit in a group, every person will be giving their ideas, and idea sharing will be done because of brainstorming, right? The more you share, the more the suggestions you get from the others will improve a lot, right? So this is one of a technique to get a idea generation, that is brainstorming. Okay, then in the next slide, I had said about the selection of the product. After having an idea, the idea, you will be selecting the product. Then I said, if you visit the trade fairs and exhibition, you will be knowing which product is going on, what is the competition of the product. Okay, what is the demand of the product? What are the demand analysis? What is the cost analysis? I had given a tea and a coffee as an example, isn't it? So selecting a product, when you select a product, the question marks you should have, the questions you should have is, what are the import restrictions? Is the product what you wanted to launch is having a licensing problem, or whether it could be a patented product, or it could be whether it is from the free trade zone. Yesterday we had seen one of the term called free trade zone, where you will be not having the customs duty. There are some areas whereby you can have a trading of the product. Right, so we had seen what is a customs duty product, where you can see zero customs duty product in the airports. Okay, so these are the points you have to put it in your brain when you select a product, in terms of marketability, in terms of demand, what could be the future demand of that product. Okay, then in the next slide, I had explained the classification of the methods of obtaining the product. There are three types of producing the product in your firm. Either it could be, the first one is internal development. Internal development is discovering and developing the product of your own product, or you can see that the new product what you are manufacturing, it is of yourself. Then you no need of taking the rights or the legal agreement. But whereas the licensing is nothing but you will be taking the securing rights of the patent. You will be taking the patent, or you will be having a contractual agreement, and you will produce the product. The third one is the acquisition. Acquisition is nothing but you will be buying the firm which is already having the patent rules, and then you will be improving the product. So these are the three types. Then coming to today's topic, we will see the topic called the adoption process. From here, I will be slow because I am really fast. When I listen to my video after going home, I am really speaking very fastly. So from now, from today's slide, I will be slower my vocabulary. Okay, so coming to this process, it's a topic called the adoption process. The adoption process is nothing but it is a process bringing out a change in a buyer's attitude and perception. Right, I'll repeat the definition of the adoption process. Adoption process is a process bringing out a change in buyer's attitude and perception. Okay, see, let's say I'm a buyer of a company, right? I wanted to buy a bottle which is used for packing the beverages or juices. So I would like to have a tender. I would like to give a tender to a company so that I need 100 bottles, and my requirement is 100 bottles. So what this company people will do, they will try to give more information, like I will be having some knowledge about the bottle. My bottle height should be of 10 centimeters. My diameter of the bottle should be of 5 centimeters. I should have black cap. The aesthetic look of my bottle should be very good. Okay. And my bottle should be like it should be use and throw type. This is my requirement, right? So what this company will generally, my that whatever the knowledge I have, that you call it as awareness is nothing but the general knowledge what a buyer will be having. The, let's say I said, right, my bottle should be having a so and so height, so and so diameter, the aesthetic look should be good, it should have a black cap, and it should be an of a use and throw plastic bottle. So the general information of a buyer, you call it as awareness. Okay, coming to the second part, interest. Interest is nothing but now what I do when I approach a company, let's say an XYZ company is manufacturing 10 bottles to me. So now what I will do, I will go to this XYZ company and I will tell that these are my requirements. So what they do, this XYZ company, they will be giving some more points to me. No, madam. You are telling this black cap and height you are telling, but usually if you have more height and the more diameter, you will get more quantity to be filled. And the aesthetic look, they will show you some more choices, right? Initially, I'll be having only one model in my brain. But what they will do, the XYZ company, they will be showing you some 2-3 varieties. So you can, the second stage is nothing but out of your interest, what you will do, you will be selecting. You will be getting more features, right? By own on myself, I'm having only one type of height and diameter and the one type of aesthetic. But when you approach this XYZ, you will be adopting some more features of the bottle, isn't it? Then in the third stage, I had written here, evaluation. Evaluation is nothing but here after having a talk with XYZ company, they had shown you some 3 or 4 varieties. So now you will be the buyer, whatever myself, what I will do, I will be evaluating which is very good, which information is, I will be weighing now. Weighing now is nothing but I will be choosing which is best out of it. Okay, then in the third stage, what I will do, I will be doing trial, right? Trial is nothing but just checking whether the height and diameter, the look, or the bottle color, or the whether the bottle is giving me the sufficient quantity of the liquid what I wanted to store. All these I will be, all in all aspects, I will be doing the trial and I will do some prototype. Then in the last stage, adoption. Now you will adopt. Now we will adapt to the bottle, the design of the bottle given by the XYZ company. And now you will tick. Okay, I'm okay with this bottle height, diameter, and the look, and whatever the plastic, whatever they are giving. Now I'm okay with it. So these are the different stages what a buyer will be having a rapport with a company. So initially the awareness, what he is having the general information. Second, interest, out of like he will be having a rapport with the company people, and he will be choosing the best out of it. Evaluation, trial, and adoption. So these are the procedure where a product is being bought by a buyer. The procedure how the talk will be there between the company people and the buyer. The dealings between a buyer and a company, or a firm and a buyer, is called as an the adoption process. Is it clear? Boys and girls, is it clear? No one is talking.
Yes, ma'am, it's clear.
So if you don't talk now, I don't know whether you are listening. It's just like talking to the system. Are you clear, girls and boys? Please respond.
Yes, ma'am. You are clear.
Ma'am.
Yes, right. So if you wanted in terms of definition, I will provide you my notes. Just I had explained in terms of example. There are definitions for the awareness, interest, evaluation, trial and adoption. So can I read the definition from my notes? Shall I read the definition or is it enough?
Read, ma'am.
Okay. Let me read the definition. All of you, please listen. Okay, the adoption process. It is a process of bringing about a change in buyer's attitude and perception. The definition of awareness. Awareness is nothing but the person who is having a general information through advertisement and limited knowledge is called as an awareness. Coming to the interest. Interest is nothing but it is a stage where he develops an interest in innovation and he tries to gather more detailed information is called as an interest. Coming to the evaluation. Evaluation is nothing but in this stage he will be weighing the accumulated information and evidence. Trial is nothing but here he will be doing the studying on the prototype and he will remove all the unnecessary part and he will go to the adapted part, right? Coming to the adoption. Adoption is a final stage which the buyer makes a decision to buy and now he will adopt to the new product what is being launched. That is called as an adoption, right? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Yes. Coming to the next slide, the next topic is product planning and development strategy. And one thing, students, are you writing whatever am I telling or you are just simply listening to me? Are you maintaining any running notes? No one is listening, ma'am. You're just listening. If you just listen, after 1 hour, it will vanish from your brain. That is a human tendency. Even if I listen to 1 hour lecture, after 2 hours, if you ask me, it's a common thing. Only 10% I will tell, but the rest of thing will vanish. I suggest all the students, if I tell something, just write running notes. Running notes, maintaining running notes is very, very, very important. It's a professional, when you're a final year student, I'm telling my experience. I worked in Capgemini, it's a software company. So what they used to do, my manager, he used to call me and he used to give me the some meeting points. You call it as minutes, okay? So what they do, they'll be just talking continuously, but you have to write whatever he's telling in just shortcuts. Previously, in past days, you call it as shorthand writing. They write it very fastly in some symbols and they convert it and then they type it. But the same thing, right? Whatever I say it, you just write some bullet points so that when you refer the PPT when I'm sharing, you will recollect. Okay, madam said at this PPT some topics. She correlated with a bottle. She correlated with a car. She correlated with a mobile. So it will help you to recollect. So I suggest all the students, I will never demand the students, I request you just write some points, whichever it is useful to you. So let's say I'm taking the topic called product planning and development strategies. Just write the topic and listen to it. Okay. So this is a topic called product planning and development strategy. So it will show you how the product is being converted from the ideas stage to the last commercialization. From the initial idea stage to the last commercialization, how the product is being developed from one step to the other step. Now we will see here. Okay, so here I had written here the four Okay, the four basic alternative approaches for the sales growth. Okay, the four, these the I had given here the four different names. The first one is market penetration, market development, product development, diversification. So these are the four different approaches whereby you can make your product to have a huge sales in the market. In order to get profits or in order to get more sales from your product, you can use either of this. From these four different methods, you can choose any one. And these are the approaches to make your product to get more growth or to get more profitability of the product. Let's see this in detail in the next slide. Okay, the first one is market penetration. Market penetration is nothing but, let me explain in detail. All of you see this diagram? Okay, I'm sorry, what is this? Give me a while. Yes. Okay. Market penetration. This is a technique where you will be using, let's say, I'm manufacturing a bottle which is an existing product in the market. So what I will do, you will try to expand the sales of the product, sales of your existing bottles in the existing market. In the sense, I will be trying to sell my bottles to the already known buyer. Let's say I'm the known buyer for about past 10 years. I am buying the bottle from XYZ itself. What this XYZ company will do? He will try to increase the number of units. For 1 year, he will be doing 100. And in the second year, he will be suggesting the buyer, okay, madam, you can increase your the products. You can take 100, 200. We will be giving you the discount or we will be giving you some extra features of it. So what this XYZ company will do, he will try to sell the bottles, more amount of bottles to the known customer, that you call it as market penetration. Okay, second one is market development. Market development is nothing but, what you will do, the same bottles, whatever the bottles XYZ is manufacturing, he will try to move to the new market. Okay, he will try to sell this same bottles to other person also. The same features, the same bottles, but he will try to have a rapport with an other market, and he will try to expand his company. Right? The first one, what he's doing? He's trying to increase his quantity of the bottles to the same customer, to the same market. But in the second one, the same, he's not doing any improvement, but he's selling the same bottles to the new market. Thereby, what he will do, he will be expanding his company in different markets. In different markets, he's selling the same product. That you call it as market development. Okay, the third one is product development. Product development is what he's doing. He is changing the product. The XYZ company, he's changing the bottle to some features. He's changing. He's making some new bottles. And now he's trying to sell the new type of bottles to the same customer, the old customer itself. He's trying to do the advertisement. He's trying to do commercialization of his company by selling some new products to the existing market. That you call it as a product development. Thereby, he is developing the product in the same market, right? The last one is diversification. Diversification is nothing but you will be developing the new products, and you will be choosing different markets, new markets you will be choosing, and you will be launching the new products in the new market. That you call it as a diversification. isn't it? So in diversification is nothing but you are doing something new, and it is a risk taking because you don't know the idea of the customer. In previous cases, you know that the madam is having the requirement, anyhow she will be taking the product. If you add some features to that, she will be accustomed to the company. But if you do the diversification of the company, diversification is nothing but you will be launching the new product in the new market. So neither you will be having a market expertise or you will not having the knowledge of the product. You will be doing some, like, because of this diversification you will have the scope of innovation, right? So the more new things, the more new features, the more new things you do, that will grab the attention of the market, isn't it? The basic example is Amazon. What they do, if you see what I had studied from Amazon, if I select a product in an Amazon, what it will do, it will show the same product at the bottom, but it will show the price variation, features variation, and it will show the colors or the whatever the different the product features or the similar products at the same price or at a lower price. So that's the way, like the Amazon, what he had done, rather choosing a single product, you will have a choice, isn't it? You will have a choice to select the more the same features at a lower price, right? So diversification is I think every entrepreneur, he has to try diversification if he wants to do some innovation or some new things, because he is launching a new product at the new market and he is taking the risk. If it is okay, he will go to the up. If it is not okay, if the product is not good, or it is not chosen by the people, or if the features is not much, or the cost of the product is not much, he will go down. So he is taking the risk here. Okay, so that's why I had shown you here a matrix sort of thing. So A, B, C, D. A is market penetration, where it is having a linkage between it is an existing product in an existing market. B is a market development, which is an existing product in a new market. C, product development, which is a new product in an existing market. D is nothing but it is a new product in a new market. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
B plus B on the line. I'm getting a call. 1 minute. Please be on the line. 1 minute, sir. Hello.
Yeah, ma'am. You are.
Yes. Okay. Fine. Is it clear for you, the whatever the matrix I'm showing, there are four different varieties of approaches whereby you can have a sales growth of the product which you are launching. Is it clear?
Yeah,
is it
ma'am.
Clear? All of you, the civil and triple E, if you want, I will read the definition for you. Let me read the definition, because some people may understand my explanation and some people may not understand my explanation. Let me read the definition of the four different approaches. The first one is the market penetration. Market penetration, it involves the expansion of the sales of the existing product in the existing market by selling more to the present customer. So you will be using the existing product and in the existing market. Okay, second one is market development. Market development is nothing but the present product is introduced in a new market or a new segment. It is a creation of a new market by discovering new applications for the existing goods is called as a market development. Okay, coming to the product development, A firm introduced and introduces a new product into an existing market is called as in a product development. The best example for this is a new synthetic fibers for a non-textile product is the example. So in a new, in a non-textile products, if you introduce a new synthetic fibers, so that gives an another cloth, right? That is an example for the product development. Coming to the diversification, it is introducing a new product in a new market is called as an a diversification. In diversification, neither of an owner will have a market expertise nor he will have a product knowledge. The more scope of innovation can be done in diversification. So this is a definition about the four different approaches. Am I clear? Okay. Yes, can I go to the next slide now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is a slide of what are the steps involved in the product planning and development process. I said it is a process where it is a step-by-step process where the product is being carried from the ideas to the last commercialization. So these are the steps. The first step is ideas. This is a step one. Where you will be generating the ideas. Step two is you will be screening which are good and which are out of box. You will be removing. Screening is nothing but you will be filtering the ideas and you will be choosing one out of the best. Not one out of the best. Either it could be three out of the best or five out of the best. Okay, then in the third stage, you will be doing the concept development and testing is nothing but where you will be now taking the in this stage, what you will do if you are having the three ideas now, the finalized three ideas, you will ask the customer to have a view. You will ask him to comment on the ideas. You will also take the opinion from the customers or the buyers and then you will be improvising the ideas. That you call it as concept development and testing. Okay, then in the fourth one, what you will do, the business analysis is nothing but it is a combination of market research, cost benefit analysis, demand analysis, what is the profitability if I launch the product, that all you will do it in the step four. Then in the step five, what you will do, in the step five, you will make a prototype. Prototype, you know what is a rapid prototyping? How many of you know what is a rapid prototyping? I think all the final year students will have an awareness of rapid prototyping. What is that rapid prototyping? You're not talking, students. Please talk. Hello? Shall I pick or you will talk? What is rapid prototyping? What is rapid prototyping? None of you have an answer? Just type it in Google and tell me what is a rapid prototyping. Civil and triple E. I request anyone, please answer. If you are unable to mute, you can just text me. Unmute your mics and talk. What is rapid prototyping?
It's actually a technique for quickly fabricating and scaling the physical parts of model, like three-dimensional computer, something like that.
Okay. Still any more answers?
Rapid prototyping is a group of techniques used to quickly fabricate a cycle model of physical part or assembly using three-dimensional computer. Design data. Construction of the part or assembly is usually done using 3D printing or additive layer manufacturing technology.
Okay, do this rapid prototyping techniques are used in civil and triple E?
Ma'am, it's a 3D printing usually done by the additive manufacturing technology.
Okay, still any answers from Tripoli? from EEE.